the city of Philadelphia is one of rich history and passion, and you can always count on the latter when you step inside Lincoln Financial Field. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup on tap, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Throwing first play is Lance. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
I do think it's fair to say they were caught off guard a little bit. We decided not to throw it on first down. But give them credit. They recovered in time to deny him the first down yardage. But it's only second and short. So that run is still likely to lead to a new set of downs.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. And Lance now to throw. Able to hit his target, Lance. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
On first and 10, here's Lance. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Walton. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
Now this defense for the Eagles, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
No matter what coverage was called, they were right in the hip pockets of the receivers all game long, step for step, running their routes with them. Turned out they were right there every time the ball was in the air, and they came away with 5 interceptions in that one.
And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
He'll take it inside the 25.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Second down and 8. Now a carry for Walton. And that would cover beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop it by the line. They fake the handoff. Now Lance out to his left. Nothing open downfield.
You're in field goal range, so you definitely don't want to be loose with the ball. And that's great work by this defense to force a fourth down.
Now Harrison Butker for the field goal try. This from 44 yards out, left hash. Butker's kick here is good. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. And they're going to give it to him on the jet sweep. And he'll get this one across the 20, but only up to about the 21. Here's second and 7. Now Hurts going to shift him around a bit. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. This is Smith with a grab. And he will step out of bounds all the way down inside the 40. A big play there for Philly. 41 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Sets up to throw it. And it's caught. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. That's good for a gain of 6. Second and goal.
At the 1-yard line.
Swift is into the end zone. Touchdown for
As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
Elliott good with a PAT. And that makes it a 7-3. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they were winners the last time they took the field, which was 2 weeks ago. They had the open week last week. So this is a squad that should be really refreshed and ready to roll.
I would agree, because when you get that open week after a victory, it does wonders for everyone. Obviously, your body, get a chance to heal up, but your mind as well. You feel good about winning, so now you can get away from it for a few days, put down the playbook, you know, turn off the film. Just be you. Enjoy that time away, and then you come back ready to go.
Second down and 6 now. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. You look at this Eagle defense. They were excellent a week ago in that victory over the Colts.
I don't know what the actual percentages are. I don't know the analytics on when you create 5 turnovers or takeaways in a game.
But coaches have always told me, when you create a number that high, your chances of winning probably up over 98%.
They work now on second and nine.
Ready?
On play action, Lance. He finds his man complete. It's Walton. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Throwing on second down. That is caught, Schoonmaker. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and ten. Steps away. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that'll bring up second down.
He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Now a second and six. Now a handoff looking right. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. After 1-7-3, the score on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got it with a third down coming up. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Throwing is Lance on third down. And that is incomplete. A nice play defensively, and now brings up fourth down.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top two teams right now in that division.
And if you could build a bit of a cushion as you head towards the second part of the season, that allows you to survive the expected injuries, potential upset losses, all of those things, and still be in good shape.
They go play action with Hurts. He'll buy some time right. And he whips that one incomplete there.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. From the gun, it's Hurts. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Partner, we've got ourselves a ball game, and those guys on defense, they came to play. Slipped up on their first series, but they're definitely settling in now and letting it be known that points won't come so easy again.
Yeah, the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 15. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
He finds his man complete. It's Walton. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. It's a gain of 34.
Well, he booked his way quite a bit in this first half, and with good reason. You can see it there. He is such a handful defensively, just too hard to keep him under wraps. It delivers a big play here for this offense.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Brought down that time by Nolan Smith.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top five, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try to run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
Third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Here's Lance to throw it. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, Lance has it knocked free. The ball is loose. And this is going to kick out the Rams, but unfortunately, it's a 2-0. They keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. Can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone came around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. This is Swift on the counter. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down. The Eagles at 5-1 here in this early part of the season. They're in a real groove of late. Winners of 5 of their last 6.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
They'll stay on the ground with Swift, and they'll get this just to the 47, 1-yard gain.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people, because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers, because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marquise Bell down the left sideline. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. But no surprise to see that one, partner. The league's number one defense coming through with a huge pick 6.
And it's plays like that one that have made them the most feared group to face this year. Offenses, they're trying to figure out how to work around them rather than work through them. Big-time impact playmakers scattered throughout the unit on every level, and they can change a game at a moment's notice.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes this a 9-point game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down.
An 11-yard loss on the play brings up 3rd down.
Right now, let's go get 6.
Right now, let's go get
the points on the board.
Now Hurts changing up the play.
We can do this on offense.
Let's go.
Make a play here. Just be patient. Just take the goal. Keep going.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. Down the right sideline, DeAndre Swift. Touchdown, Philadelphia. DeAndre Swift. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Eagles are back within a score. Elliott now to add the extra point. And it's good. It cuts it to two. 16-14. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
Now a second and 10. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. And he takes this one back in the end zone. Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD. In a tight game like this, that could be an incredibly important pick six, CD. And remember, it cancels out the one that the opposition had earlier in this ball game.
You're right about that, partner, because each side came up with plays to swing the momentum their way. Still plenty of time for either team to come through with a win now. Can someone else make a similar play and win it for their club?
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. On that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Here's a give up the middle, and they'll hustle up to stop him well shy of the first right on 15. Now the Eagles will use the 2nd of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. There, this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Already ready at the line. This Philly offense set to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Hurts. Who finds his receiver, Watson. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. On first down, Hurts. And that one going to come up short. No throw. He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late, and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
They'll throw now on the final play. Forced out to his left. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. And it's knocked away and incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. We welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here.
Harrison Butker is set to kick off.
So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well. And most importantly, partner.
And they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
And not a whole lot there, maybe a yard to the 27. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Smith, the man in motion left. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. A big play that time on the catch and run. 34 yards.
On third down, it's very simple. Make sure you get beyond the sticks, make the catch, pick up the first down. But in this case, he turned it into bonus time and was off to the races for a monster play.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Hurts throw complete here to his receiver Brown. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. Throwing is Hurts. Through the middle of the field. Touchdown! Devontae Smith. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Eagles are able to stretch out their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Elliott on for the extra point. Now he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he gets another one through. Touched in the lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Now this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They make their second half debut here. Things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a three-possession game.
Here's 2nd and 10. Working from the gun, Lance. He finds his man, complete. It's Gallagher. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. First target, first catch, and a first down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. Here's Lance. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown in the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanket in the field, going all the way back to the opening drive. And they come up with a pick right there.
12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A good pick up there at 20 yards.
I like watching the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
They sent the man in motion too late. This is going to be a delay. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. The delay of game backs them up 5, 1st and 15. A handoff, Swift running to the left. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line.
Brought down back at the 27.
Now Hurts looking to change the play.
Throwing on second and long. Hurts. And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
And that could have been the lifeline they needed. This is a play that could have been made. Instead, it's just going to fall incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hurts. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
Hurts completing this one quickly.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
From the gun, he'll hand this over.
And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about three. Well, they've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal?
It'll be Hurts on the option.
And he's in. Touchdown. Jalen Hurts keeping it himself from a yard out as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with the drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Elliott good on the extra point. And that will make this a 19-point game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Now second and nine. Lance looking to throw it.
Oh, he had a man open. He overshot it.
Oh, that's kind of how it's going for him. So he knows why they need to get back in this game. Touch you with a big play. But he led his guy too far, and it winds up over his head.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
The Lance going to throw.
In trouble here, and down he goes.
Finally held down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
I think we've seen this before.
someone's down three scores, that situation there just going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number three right now. Three-score game, third quarter, three and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And he is going to have the Cowboys first down. And it is a big letdown there defensively. They somehow allowed to convert on fourth and long. To throw, it's Lance. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 37, they work on second and six. And they fake the handoff. Now Lance. And he'll be hit as he releases it. He had to absorb another one bumped in from the defense, another incomplete pass. We've seen a lot of that tonight.
They've come after him all night long. Nothing but pressure in his face. He's trying to stand up there and make throws. It's hard enough to do when the pocket is clear. When you got all those people in front of you, almost impossible to have a good completion percentage.
Throwing now is Lance. He's got his target. That's complete. Down the sideline he goes. Touchdown, Cowboys. A big play there. 63 yards. And the Cowboys have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Well, forget about the weapons out wide. He knows he's got another weapon in the backfield in the passing game, Charles, and he utilized him perfectly on that play.
And the offense coordinator showed me something on that play, Brandon, because so often during a game, our cameras find them looking down at their play sheets, and you wonder if they're absorbing anything. He had something specific in mind, and he went to it, and it worked well.
The Cowboys offense, it'll stay out there as they'll go for two.
Ready?
Lance going to try to throw for this. Rolling to his right. And they're going to get the two-point conversion caught in the end zone. And that cuts the lead a bit further. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
A break there for this offense as they will get a chance to start at the 40-yard line. Well, you don't see that often. He just mishit it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I know sitting up here, and I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, and I know we're both thinking the same thing. Isn't it easy enough to keep it between the sidelines? Because unless you're intentionally doing it for some reason, but that's a costly mishit, and now you put your team in a bad spot.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at the 40. They'll set up to throw. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. Now he's loose again, and finally taken down at the 15. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. And this is caught. Touchdown! DeAndre Swift with touchdown number three here in this game and 17 now on the year. And the Eagles add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Elliott now to add the extra point. Go, go, go.
And the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this fourth quarter. They'll start on the ground here on first down, and able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. And they're going to speed things up here. Now Lance looking to change it up. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Being chased out left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
Come on. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Here's Lance to throw it. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. And the offense moving quickly to the line. A big loss on the play. Brings up second down. Looks like they'll move things around here.
Right here, right now.
Throwing on second and long. Hurts airing it out deep for Smith. Touchdown. 57 yards. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. And certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ballgame.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack the defense and take them out of the game.
And they open the lead up now to 25. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play
to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 60 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 16 times.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities, and we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big gain.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
Off of play action, here's Lance. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Josh Sweat rushing in and bringing him down to the ground. But defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They got a big
and pressure coming, and they got him once again.
Let's go, Eagles.
10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a 3.
Let's go, Eagles.
On the set.
Though certainly in a pickle here, they have a mile to go to try to pick up the first. We'll see what they've drawn up. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Big sack with a loss of 5. Desperation time here. Lance. He sets to fire deep. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And now the football is going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Sliding out of the pocket. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
I did like his decision making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down. And don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
Well, Brandon, we see why it's a team game there, because there's a sigh of relief that they just released defensively. If he's able to get that one away, that's likely a touchdown. But instead, that pressure from the front got to him and forced the incompletion.
You're right. He had him open just a split second too late on the release. And he's going to be a yard short. A 2-yard pickup leads to 4th and 1. Oh, they're changing this at the line. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going to get that to his run back. And he will get down to the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And you wonder now if he might be able to remove the helmet, put on the baseball cap, and watch the rest of this one from the sideline. His 5th touchdown pass of the game.
Say that again. Did you say 5th touchdown pass of the game?
Yes, sir.
Boy, that's a heck of a performance, isn't it? Because they've had no answer for him at all game long. Receivers have been open constantly, and he hasn't missed a single one of them.
Elliott good on the extra point. And this one was over the end zone as he just add on to that big lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Cowboys take over first down again at their own 22-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Check, man. Ready?
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll get this up to about the 40. 66 yards rushing for him now to this point.
If you're in the offensive huddle, you're smiling after that play because you've certainly got them guessing now. Second and short, could they just hand it off for another big gain? Or did they take advantage of this spot to take a big shot downfield?
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
But, partner, the defense isn't going to adjust, and they keep giving them those 5, 6, 7-yard runs over and over. They're likely to run it the whole way to the end zone. They'll be more than happy to take the yardage available and save some of their other plays in the playbook for another time.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. His carries tonight, they're getting up there. So maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory.
You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Okay, here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Lance now on first down. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. From the gun, it's Lance. Oh, hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people around. Just some pressure. Fortunate just to get
out. The reason for down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Shotgun now for Lance. And he's going to be sacked. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down. And they'll go for it. Lance. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this defense will take over right at midfield. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. So three Eagles fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And I tell you what, one thing that you and I featured as a storyline was that they were facing the NFL's number one defense coming in, and they really took it right to them.
Yeah, they didn't blink, did they? And instead of just saying to themselves, let's make sure that we minimize our